Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. This is going to be a quick guide for anyone who's using scrcpy and they want to use more than one device. So I don't believe there's a limit, but you can definitely at least get two devices running. I've only got two, so I can't test any more, but two should be plenty. If you're unfamiliar with scrcpy, it lets you view and control your Android device on your Windows 10 or 11 PC. So you can do anything you like with it. You can stream from OBS or something once you have it on the screen, pretty much anything you want. I've done a fair few videos of these and I've got a playlist in my playlist group down below. So if you want more info on a ton of different things related to this, definitely check it out. So without further ado, we'll just jump straight into using it. So I'll just close this window and we can start. First thing you need to do is open command prompt as administrator. So go to the start menu, search command, so type CMD, right click and select run as administrator, accept the Windows security prompt, and command prompt will open. Okay, so from here you need to point command prompt to where you have your scrcpy folder. So mine's on H drive, so I'll do H colon to change the drive. Then I will get the exact location. So the easiest way to do this is to open File Explorer, go to location where you have it. Mine is this location here. Okay, so then right click, copy address, and paste it back into command prompt. However, CD first, space, then paste in the location. Then press enter. And it will change to that exact location. Now, the next thing you need to do is make sure you have both devices connected. So I'll just plug my second device in now. Okay, so it's connected. Now, once that's connected, you need to run the following command, which will give you the device number for your two devices or three devices. So the command is adb space devices dash L. Once you've got that, press enter and it will show you your attached devices. So each device is assigned a serial number and that will tell you what it is. So I've got a HTC U11 and a Samsung M31. So those are my two devices. Now for the next step, you need to do the following command. So I'll just copy it. That's the command. Then you need to grab the serial number for the device you wish to connect. So copy it, space, and enter. And the device will pop up. Mine popped up on the other screen. So that's it there. Now, to do the next one, grab your second device. Just copy the code down. Okay, so copied the code, close, or minimize that window, I should say, because if you close it, scrcpy will close. Now, open command prompt again, as administrator, obviously. Accept the security prompt one more time. Okay, now we go through the same process again. So H to change the drive. Go back to File Explorer. Get your exact location. That's mine. CD space, the location, and the directory will change. So now you can run the second device. So copy the scrcpy --serial, space, then enter your second device serial number with a space, obviously. So it will look something like that. Then press enter and your second device will pop up. So I'll just minimize this and drag it across. Okay, so that's the second device. Now you can use them both at the same time and do whatever you want. Oh, they're mine disconnected. Anyway, that's how it works. So that was both devices running. You can do this with as many devices as you want. However, you will get stuck with the fact that you probably only have so many USB ports unless you're using a USB hub. But the more you run, the more it's going to drain. So eventually the quality will get bad. So I probably wouldn't use more than two. But that's pretty much it. So I do have a few other videos, like I said earlier. I'll just bring one of the ideas I suggest you do up quickly. So this will make life a little easier. I do have a video on this as well. Where are we? Okay, so this is my custom scrcpy bat file. So this file allows you to run set commands automatically. So when you double click the shortcut, it will run these commands automatically. So theoretically, and I haven't done this yet, but you could run the serial command for both devices. So if you were to enter, let's just copy this across. So if you were to enter this, followed by your device number, then the same again with the other device number, should bring them both up at the same time. Let's just try it actually, because I haven't tried this before. Okay, so they will be my batch file command so far. So that should open one device, that should open a second device. Just press Control S to save it, and we will give it a quick test. Okay, let's start from scratch. Okay, so that didn't work. We'll only bring up one. So let's try. We'll copy the code for the first one. Make a new batch file. So new text document. Okay, that's number two. I forgot to change the end, so rename it BAT. Yes, change the extension. Right click, edit. Okay, so we'll try run that and save it. And I'll go back and edit the first one. And that's for one other device. So now we have two different batch files, one for each device. So double click the first one. Opens up the HTC U11. Double click the second one and it opens up the Samsung device. So worked quite well. So I'll just bring this up again. So if you want to replicate this, you can just copy it straight out of the bat file that I've got here. Okay, so that's the string that I'm using. So if you want to use the same one, feel free. Obviously, you'll want to have a different serial number, but you can go to the GitHub page and there is a ton of other commands and shortcuts and whatnot you can use. So feel free to customize it as you like. But as I said, there is another playlist and video specifically dedicated to making a bat file in that playlist. So it's probably the best way to check if you want a little bit more info on it. Anyway, that wraps up this guide. Not as hard as most people probably thought. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time.